excitement mounts outside Tabernacle, Morriston, as this part of South Wales stokes up its welcome to the Prince of Wales. Since his investiture at Carnarvon 2 days ago, the Prince has travelled down through rural Wales, and now here on the outskirts of Swansea, which he declared a city this afternoon to everyone's delight, here he's on the edge of industrial Wales. At this church, the affection of Wales for her new prince is to be expressed through the traditional Gamanfa Gani, or singing festival, in which he'll take part. The congregation of 1,300 is to be conducted by Alan John. The organist is to be Erwin John. So, songs of praise in the presence of the Prince of Wales, whose arrival here is expected at any minute.
I thought we might link just for a moment two cities, the city of St. David, the old city, and the city of Swansea. There's A very old Welsh author, his name is Rhugyfarch. And he mentions a certain assembly, the kings and the princes, the bishops and the clerics and the populace at large, they had all come together to this assembly in Llandewi Brefi. And they had all come to listen to a preacher. And I suppose that this preacher's voice was scarcely audible. So they sent for Dewi Sant. And there was a small lad in the congregation, and St. David asked the small lad for his handkerchief. And St. David placed the handkerchief on the ground, and the ground rose beneath his feet. I doubt very much whether this is a true historical account, but at least it's a parable. A parable with a very distinct theme. Codi'r ddaear, codi ddaear Cymru. If I may be so bold as to translate freely, elevating the tone of the nation. Many people have come to Wales. Some have come here as strangers, and they have remained as strangers. They have kept aloof. Others have merely passed through, and at best they have received a very superficial view of the nation. They have admired the scenery, but there has been no involvement. The highest compliment I can pay you as a young man of outstanding character in this place this evening is that you have already involved yourself in the life of this nation. You have given the respect due to our heritage, culture, and language. And I feel assured that this is a prelude to still a greater and deeper involvement. This, Gymanvergan, is a mark of our esteem. And above all, an expression of our dependence as a nation and a prince upon God in his love and infinite mercy. Croeso cynnes, cynnes iawn i'n plith ni.
And now to the tune Blaen Wern, and a hymn that's become known and loved the world over, Calon Lan.
Yeah.
Calon Honest, Calon Lan. For those of you who may have heard the words often without knowing their meaning, the hymn is about an honest, pure heart. The congregation here at Tabernacle, Morriston, sing now in English to the tune Hanover, Richard Grant's hymn, O Worship the King, All Glorious Above. From the exultant major of that hymn to the minor key of the tune Llef, which means simply a cry. The words are by David Charles of Carmarthen, and they date from a time when Methodism in Wales was in its infancy, a couple of centuries ago. This hymn is a prayer for the help of Jesus in the business of living, O Iesu Mawr.
Thank you. This indeed is an extra bonus. It's my pleasure and privilege to invite the prince to address the congregation. Don't you worry about your mutations. At least you are aware of their existence more than can be said of many Welsh people. Rhowch chi fyny i'r fan hon i siarad.
Well, thank you very much indeed for your kind welcome here this evening. Sorry to disappoint you, but I'm not going to try any mutations. I don't think I could possibly do it. Like, as always, coming to one of these Cymaun Fy Gwnïs is a wonderful musical experience for anybody, particularly me. And having been to one already in Newquay, I've never forgotten. And it was a great pleasure to come here this evening and to hear you all sing so beautifully and so loudly. I can never get over it. You get nothing like this in England at all. After today, I have nothing but Welsh ringing in my ears and the voices of Welsh people. I've been most touched by the welcome I've received, and particularly here this evening, and for all your kind words. And I look forward to many more of these sort of occasions. And I think this is a very, very good way of preserving the Welsh language and the Welsh culture here by singing it particularly. And the more we do this, the more people will be interested in it. And I'm sure it will go on to survive many, many generations. Ydych chi canu yn iawn, diolch yn fawr.
I shan't be able to live with him now for the rest of the week. Diolch yn fawr iawn I chi. Now, I suppose, in a way, this is our national hymn, Emyn Ilfed.
Thank you.
Now the male voice choirs sing a hymn by T. Rowland Hughes, a contemporary of many here tonight. Tadi arodais liu ir waur, thou who gavest colour to the dawn. This church was founded in 1872, since when many distinguished congregational preachers have served it. One of them was also a hymn writer, J.J. Williams, minister here a few decades ago, and he wrote Anot Arglwydd Gorfoleddwl, In Thee, Lord, We Rejoice. The tune, Pant Gwyn.
Yeah.
theme of the next hymn is one that's inspired many hymn writers, the supreme sacrifice on the hill of Calvary, or in Welsh, Pen Calvaria. To Calvary I turn my face. The tune, Price. The best loved hymns of Wales are either gentle and rather sad, often in the minor key, or boldly exultant, tremendously inspiring, like this next one, Diadem, a tune transposed by T.G. Richards. Edward Perrinet's hymn, All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. We sing next a hymn by Avion Wynne to the tune Cirioldeb by Dr. Joseph Parry. One blessing give me, in vendith diroim. So to a hymn that perhaps more than any other symbolizes Wales to the world outside, and which finds favor in the build-up to big football games as much as in the Gymanfa Ganu. It's known by its tune, John Hughes's Cwm Rhondda, Rhondda Valley, and the words are a translation from the original by Wales's greatest hymn writer, William Williams of Pantycelyn. Guide me, O thou great Jehovah.
Thank you.
eight choirs and congregation here now sing a hymn by Watkin Wynne to the tune Pembroke by John Foster. It looks forward to the day when all the kingdoms of the world will be ruled by the Spirit of Christ and will acknowledge him Lord of Lords. Ruin gweld o bell a dydd yn dod. So to the last hymn of our service from Wales this evening in the presence of the Prince of Wales. The original words were by Charles Wesley. A scholar, D. Tecwyn Evans, translated them, and they were set to music by a man who had a profound influence on sacred music in the Principality, Dr. Joseph Parry. Jesu, lover of my soul, Jesi cavaeth venaid I. The benediction will be spoken by the Mayor's Chaplain, the Reverend Christmas Williams.
Iadre yn sŵn un fendid.
Oh. We beseech thee to bless and preserve our royal prince. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God the Father and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit abide with us all forever. Amen.